Welcome to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Shadows of Om for now. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and welcome to what many say is possibly the greatest RPG of all time. This is thus a part zero video where I'm just mostly talking about the different mods I've installed and how the settings are. And I just want to start out with a couple disclaimers. Number one, please, no spoilers at all. Hope you can hear me over the music. Maybe I'll turn it down a second. Okay, no spoilers at all, please. I am playing this game for the first time. I do know a few things, and I'm not going to spoil it for you guys. I do know something that happened to two characters, and I know that Kagan's doesn't show up in the game, nor does Branwen, two my favorite NPCs. Not completely sure how I found this out. It wasn't purposeful as far as the two characters that something happened to, and as far as Branwen and Kagan. Someone might have told me some of them. I might have come across them by mistake, you know, not meaning to when uploading mods and such. I do know about a few of the characters, the playable characters in the game. I don't know that much about them, but enough to get an idea. And that's about it. I have not played the movie, so I haven't even started the game at this point. So other than that, the couple things that were leaked out to me or I found out by mistake, I'm playing completely blind. I read all the things, so other than repeat information, obviously I'm not going to repeat the same thing the shopkeeper says over and over again. And as far as like unique weapon descriptions, anything interesting, but I'm not gonna, you know, in the first game I was reading aloud, you know, about swords and axes and stuff. I'm not gonna bother with that this time, because you can watch that in the first game. And I have played, of course, Baldur's Gate, the first enhanced edition, and I played the Black Pits as well before finishing the enhanced edition, and then I went on to Siege of Dragonspear, and now here we are with Shadows of Om. Of course, this is the enhanced edition as well, so. And what else? I read all the things, no spoilers. That's pretty much it. I have a lot of mods installed, not too many. I'm just gonna go over a few of them, all of them. Baldur's Gate 2 Unfinished Business, version 28. Adds a lot of things that were cut from the game. A lot of this stuff has been put back into the enhanced editions, but I guess there's some stuff that hasn't. They have new quests in it that, like, I think some of them warrant cut content. Just quests people added in, so that's cool. Yeah, the mods I have installed are all either, it's the user interface, which I have to get to, new quests, or some various improvements. Very minor things. So obviously, I'm playing this for the first time, so I'm not changing things with the gameplay. I'm not going to change the experience, per se. It's just going to add things. So that's what the unfinished business does. From what I can see, it mostly adds new quests to do. Back to Bryn Law, version 9. There's another one I've installed. That's a new quest or quest line. I'm going to put all these with links in the video description, guys. So if you guys want to check it out yourself. Banter Packs, volume 18. Adds additional banter between your NPCs, your playable NPCs, and you. Maybe even some non-playable NPCs, I don't even know. The Cell Swords, which is another quest mod, or quest line, series of quests. It's based on characters from the R.A. Salvatore book, The Sellswords, which I have not read, but yeah, should be interesting in any case. Hopefully it's not immersion-breaking. That's the Sellswords version 9.1. And Dungeon Crawl version 13, which is based on the webcomic Dungeon Crawl Incorporated, or Dungeon Crawlers Incorporated, I believe it's called. So it's characters from there. Lefruit's Enhanced UI version 4.4.3, which is brand new for this version. You can see I'm rising version 2.6.6.0, which is new. Pretty darn new. It's changes the UI back to the original Baldur's Gate style, for the most part, anyway. And, you know, improve spell icons and stuff like that. They pop on the screen more, things like that. And then the only other mod I have installed is called the Tweaks Anthology. And this is version 11, and it has a lot of mods inside it. So the only ones I have installed are icon improvements, fix Boo's squeak, which I think changes it from the beep, like it's someone's voice saying it, to the in the part of one of, I don't know if you can picture it, but one of Minsk's dialogues says, he says something, right, Boo, and then you hear a Boo go, you know, like, I can't even do that. So it sounds more like an actual squeak than like beep, you know, like it was sounding. So I prefer that. Just a minor thing. I wouldn't have bothered to even install that by itself. Unique icons. It's different icons, so things more stand out for you can look at it rather than just, you know, this is the same ring. This is a ring of protection plus one. Looks just like this ring of protection or this other ring. It just makes things look more separated out and individualized. Unique containers, same, but with containers. Separate resist fire and resist cold into separate icons, so you know which one it is. Add bags of holding, which a lot of these are available for multiple Baldur's Gate games, including the original games, modded games, Baldur's Gate Trilogy mod, and such. But for this, we already have bags of holding, I believe. So it just adds potion cases and ammo belts. So that's good. I like potion cases. So I don't know if those are absent from Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition, but if they are, it's putting them back in. And do not reveal city maps when entering area. From what I've seen, you go into the city and the whole thing's laid out for you. So this is the old way where you have to explore in order to uncover, you know, you got the fog of war returned into the city. So I like it. I prefer it that way, to explore and make sure, you know, maybe never been there before. So who knows that, why would we see everything, right? So it just makes it more, I guess, to the first Baldur's Gate and a little more, makes more sense, right? And then I have romance cheats to basically remove the constraints from gender and race, so I can romance anyone I want to. So we'll see what I do with that. And from what I understand, it doesn't remove the gender, so if you have somebody, I'm playing a female character, obviously, bringing over my character from the first Baldur's Gate. So if there's dialogue, I think it's still going to say, you know, like if I have somebody who will only romance a male character, so then the dialogue, she's going to be saying he this and, you know, you're a very nice man, that, so I'm going to have to improvise with reading that dialogue and change the pronouns and stuff like that back. So it could be they've changed it, but from what I heard the last time, they did not. So, and that's it. That's all the mods I have installed. Not too many compared to the first game, I think. So my plans, basically, yes, I'm going to be playing the Shadows of Om. I'm going to be playing the Black Pits. And I'm going to play Throne of Baal. So I'm probably going to play Shadows of Om before... I mean, I'm probably going to play the Black Pits before Throne of Baal. So it's just Throne of Baal straight to the end kind of thing. The other thing that I know... I'm going to separate out my playthrough from Shadows of Om and Throne of Baal. So it's going to... The numbering's going to start over from Throne of Baal. So it's going to be Let's Play Baldur's Gate... EE Throne of Baal, as opposed to now you see Shadows of Om with this, you know, this video and succeeding ones. So the only other, the other thing that I know, which is I guess kind of a spoiler, with the enhanced edition, Watcher's Keep is available from, you can get there, like, I guess before starting Throne of Baal. So the only, my only question to you guys is, do you want me to go to Watcher's Keep as part of the Shadows of Om playthrough, or you want me to get to it with Throne of Baal? That's the only thing. Otherwise, I think it's pretty clear. I don't really know the details, and please don't tell me there's some big battle or something like that. You fight a boss, and from what I understand, then it goes to Throne of Baal. So I'll know when to switch it, you know, when that'll happen, when that happens. It's going to be, I might not know at the time, but I'll be able to split the video off. So yeah, that's just my only question to you guys. It's, you know, when do you want me to go to Watcher's Keep as part of Shadows of Om or Throne of Baal? I've been playing Shadows of Om for quite a while, especially with all this added content. So you guys have time to weigh in on that. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, and see you guys in the actual... Yeah, it's going to be part one. So I'll see you guys in part... with me talking in part two. And there I'll be importing my character over. And the other thing... Yeah, the other thing I was going to go through is... Alright, I'm going to change this... I'm going to change the music back. So this is... These are my settings... Basically, I'm going to put the music back up as my last action here. So, the music I can put back up. Character sounds. In case anyone is curious, I'm pretty much keeping it the same as the first Baldur's Gate. Language, of course, English, gameplay. I have it like this. I didn't change that. Gore, weather... Rest until healed. The keys, I think these are the default keys. They're fine for me. I'm playing on core rules difficulty. Alright. So. Hit points are random. Party members can permanently die. Spell learning has a chance to fail. Opponents do full damage. So core rules difficulty, same as before in Baldur's Gate 1. That's that, yeah. And then graphics I have to this... Yeah, I just don't know if the font size is the same, hold on. I have some... took pictures of the screen, believe it or not. Gameplay... Font size. Yeah, that's the same font size. Full screen, mouse cursor. Scale user interface, grayscale and pause. Highlight selected sprite dither always. And then the movies. That's it. So. I'll see you guys in the actual game. There's going to be no character creation, of course. I'm going to be importing my character from Baldur's Gate 1 / Caesar Dragonspear. So see you guys in the first actual video. Always seek adventure.